Good rising, brethren. This is Big Judah coming to you guys from California. Before I begin, you have all praises to the Most High, Yahweh. Acknowledgement to the Earthly Mother, who is wisdom, who is Holy Spirit. Acknowledgement to Yahweh Shai. I pray that the Most High blesses this lesson this evening, gives more knowledge and understanding of the events of the past in order to understand the events that are currently happening on the earth. So we get a much better understanding of things that are soon to come on the earth. The Most High put it on me a while ago, a couple weeks ago, to read the story of Dina from the book of Jasher. I'm reading it from the Sefer. And I'm just gonna have you guys just sit and listen to the story, and you can see how the story of Dina follows the plight of the Hebrew Israelites. Gives you, when you know how to kind of look at things, you see how our story is in the story of Dina. We're going to start chapter 33, verse 10, and you're going to see the interaction between the Hebrew Israelites and also the Canaanites, who are representative of the other nations. And you'll see how it fits with what's going on right now, today. Okay? So we'll start at verse 10. And we're talking about Shechem. Shechem beheld Dina, the daughter of Jacob. And when he looked at her, his soul became fixed upon Dina. And he sent and had her taken by force. And Dina came to the house of Shechem, and he seized her and forcibly and lay with her and humbled her. And he loved her exceedingly and placed her in his house. Now, they're just like the other nations have been wanting to get at the Hebrew Israelites, but when we were with the Most High, they couldn't touch us. When they got their opportunity to actually control our people, which is what they've all the other nations have wanted this whole time, they took us by force. And like I said, Israelites, you know, the Israelites are looked at as a woman. Okay? And in many different parts of the Bible, it talks about, like, you know, the things that are the woman was going to go through. So just like Dina here was taken by force. Okay, now, let's see here, verse 12. And they came and told the thing unto Jacob. And when Jacob heard that Shechem had defiled his daughter, Dina, Jacob sent 12 of his servants to fetch Dina from the house of Shechem. And they went and came to the house of Shechem to take away Dina from there. And when they came, Shechem went out to them with his men and drove them from his house. He would not suffer them to come before Dina, but Shechem was sitting with Dina, kissing and embracing her before their eyes. So kind of like right now, Most High is sending the spirit in order to open their eyes a little bit to see how our people have been done wrong for the last 500 plus years. They've been even talking about the 400 years from 1619 to 2019. But even though they're admitting that they were wrong, they still will not let us go. So same kind of a thing is going on right now. So they know that they've done that he did Dina wrong. Just like the people here today know that they've done the, as they like to call it, still blacks and African Americans wrong. So, but they're not going to let the people go because they love us so much. And without us, they are absolutely nothing. Okay. So 12. And they came and told the thing to Jacob. And when Jacob heard that Shechem had defiled his daughter, Dina, Jacob sent 12 of his servants. Okay, we read that part already. Sorry. 13. And when they came to Shechem, went out to them with his men and drove them away from the house. Okay, read that part too. All right. Let's see here. 14. And the servants of Jacob came back and told him, saying, when we came, he and his men drove us away, and thus did Shechem do unto Dinah before our eyes. Okay? So they're still not going to admit the truth. So they're still not admitting the truth even to today. Verse 15. And Jacob knew, moreover, that Shechem had defiled his daughter, but he said nothing. And his sons were feeding his cattle in the field. And Jacob remained silent till their return. And before his sons came home, Jacob sent two maidens, okay, from his servants, daughters to take care of Dinah in the house of Shechem, and to remain with her. And Shechem sent three of his friends to his father, Chamor, the son of Chidekim, the son of Pered, saying, get me this damsel for a woman. And Chamor and the son of Chidekim, the Chivi, came to the house of Shechem, his son. And he sat before him. And Chamor said unto his son, Shechem, is there then no woman amongst the daughters of your people that you will take a Hebrew woman who is not of your people? See, they already know that, you know, mixing with the Hebrews and mixing with them, that's not something that's to be done. But see, these lies have been pushed all this time about how, you know, you can just marry whoever you love. But according to the Most High, that's not how it goes. Okay? Let's see here. Verse 18. And Shechem said to him, her only must you get for me, for she is delightful in my sight. And Chamor did according to the word of his son, for he was greatly beloved by him. And Chamor went forth to Jacob to commune with him concerning this matter. And when he had gone from the house of his son Shechem, before he came to Jacob to speak to him, behold, the sons of Jacob had come from the field. As soon as they heard the thing that Shechem, you know, the son of Chamor had done, and the men were very much grieved concerning their sister. And they all came fired with anger before the time of the gathering in their cattle. So, of course, you know, the brethren here heard what happened with Dinah, and they were upset. All right, verse 21. And they came and sat before their father, and they spoke unto him, kindled with wrath, saying, surely death is due to this man and to his household. Okay, because Yahweh Elohim of the whole earth commanded Noach and his children, that man shall never rob nor break wedlock, nor behold Shechem has both ravaged and committed fornication with our sister. And not one of all the people of the city spoke a word to him. So there's your Psalms 83. How they've been doing all these things to us, but the whole world is silent. Now Shechem, you know, took Dinah and violated her, and no one in the city. So now we've come to the 400, into the 400 years. And we see how the Most High has allowed them to talk about the 400 years so that the whole world knows and understands that these particular people right here have been done wrong for 400 to 500 plus years. Now, what are they trying to do in the world? What you're going to see right here, what Shechem was trying to do with Dinah. Shechem had already did the deed. He'd already violated Dinah. After the fact, then he wants to try to fix the situation. But he wants to fix the thing on the situation on his terms. Okay? So right here, if you look at, if you just listen to verse 21 again, it says, Noah and his children, Yahweh Elohim of the whole earth commanded Noah and his children that man shall never rob nor break wedlock. Now behold, Shechem has both ravaged and committed fornication with our sister. And not one of all the people of the city spoke a word to him. So they're not supposed to be doing those kinds of things. They're not supposed to be raping our women. Not supposed to be raping and doing those kinds of things. And there's definitely,
you know, a price to be paid when that happens. Shechem doesn't want to pay that price. He wants to then send someone else to go and talk to Jacob and start to make the situation right. Fast forward to now. All of a sudden, you know, 2014 is, you know, these problems have been, you know, brought to a head, but nobody wanted to talk about anything. Even these athletes today, is that all of a sudden now, you know, they're like, well, maybe we shouldn't play. You know, we need to have solidarity and things like that. So you had that opportunity to do that in 2016. 2020 is a whole different animal. The reason why everyone is wanting to have that solidarity is because the Most High has already taken the dainties away. He's already taken, you know, the fun times away. Even though the whole world, especially people here in the States, want to act like the virus has just gone away. Well, it hasn't. In fact, it's coming back with a vengeance. So if you look at today, everyone now wants to say, hey, okay, you know what? Now, when these police officers, you know, like shot down the brother in Atlanta, all of a sudden they're giving these dudes all these charges. But see, and now the police are getting upset because, hey, this is what we've done the whole time. Why all of a sudden now are you guys giving us a case because we shot down, you know, these people? You guys have let us shoot them down the whole time. Why is it all of a sudden now things are changing? So that's why now you've seen all these police officers calling in sick, not going to work. Because the whole society knows that, you know, that whole institution was set up to do the things that they've been doing. So now, like I said, now you fast forward to now. People are now talking about the 400 years, you know, and you'll hear them talking about it. But now all of a sudden they want to fix it. Oh, we're going to pass, you know, we're going to pass this bill. We're going to pass that bill. We're going to come together and try to make it right. That's what you're seeing now. They want to fix things, you know, as it's comfortable to them, with them still being on top and them still calling the shots and us still having to go to them and beg them for justice. That's what they're holding on to. Same thing happened with Dina. Now remember how Dina's like representing also the Most High's people. She has been violated. When the Most High starts to send people, you know, to the house, they send them away. So just like when they get this information, they don't want to believe it. They don't want to believe who we are. They want to say, you're not the 12 tribes. You're not part of the Most High chosen people. You're black. You are African Americans. They want things under their terms, just like Shechem right here. Okay? So we're going to go down to verse 22. Surely you know and understand that the judgment of death is due to Shechem and to his father and to the whole city on account of the thing which he has done. Uh-oh, here you go. They know what the judgment is. The judgment is death, not only to Shechem, but also to his father and to the whole city because they said nothing. So now fast forward to today. You've been raped, robbing, and murdering the Most High's chosen people. You know what the judgment is. If you go to Numbers 35 and 33, it'll let you know. Read that on your own. Numbers 35 and 33 tells you. Read Jeremiah 30 and 16. I go on with verses as far as that's concerned. Revelation 13 and 10. Revelation 13, 9 and 10. Read that. So we already know that what is to be what the penalty is for these types of actions. So the penalty for doing these things to the Most High's chosen people isn't what they get to come up with. It's what the Most High says the penalty will be. Okay? So again, let's read that 22 again. Around Jasher 33:22. Surely you know and understand that the judgment of death is due to Shechem and to his father and to the whole city on account of the thing which he has done. And while they were speaking before their father in this matter, behold, Jamor, the father of Shechem, came to speak to Jacob. The words of his son concerning Dinah. And he sat before Jacob and before his sons. And Jamor spoke unto him, saying, the soul of my son Shechem longs for your daughter. I pray you give her unto him for a woman and intermarry with us. Give us your daughters, and we will give you our daughters. And you shall dwell with us in our land, and we will be as one people in the land. All right? So always want us to, just like now, let us fix these laws. Let us fix, you know, what has been done to you so that we'll take your daughters, you take our daughters, and vice versa, and we'll live together in the land. You see that? It's following the same pattern because all these different events just multiply themselves. They just repeat themselves over and over again. Verse 25, for our land is very extensive. So dwell ye and trade therein and get possessions in it and do therein as you desire. And no one shall prevent you by saying a word to you. Now, you see, that's what's going on when you look at these sports. I've been looking at some of these sports stories. It's going on with the NBA. And you start hearing about people all of a sudden, you know, talking about, hey, we need to set up some rules, some laws. No, you guys need to go back to work so that, you know, you can't just protest because what's the end? What is your plan? Leave that to the NAACP because they're the ones. You know, or leave it to the justice, you know, the Justice League, leave it to them because they're the ones that are set up to do all these things. But we've been leaving all these things to the NAACP. We've been leaving these things to all these different so-called black organizations. But nothing has been getting changed, taken care of. That's what, you know, they're always talking to us about. Hey, don't rock the boat. You guys, you African Americans, you know, you athletes, you know, you're getting money, so just, you know, pour some of that money back into the community. Well, they've been doing that, and nothing's changed. Oh well, the NBA's been giving money, you know, to these different organizations. Yeah, that still hasn't changed anything. See what you get? What many of these other nations don't understand is that we don't have to negotiate with you. Because this area right here is not your land. Everything that you have, you've gotten from the Most High. Everything that you have, you've gotten by the exploitation of the Most High's people and their lands and their resources. So it's just funny listening to them because it's like, we need to go back to them and work things out. We need to, you know, see, you know, what they're going to give us. And there's this funny lesson to, well, LeBron James makes all this money, and hopefully then with, you know, with his influence, we can eventually have, you know, a seat at the table, or we can start a conversation. See, that's the whole thing. And same thing happened here. Shechem, you know, did all these horrible things. Well, this one horrible event right here, by raping Dinah, taking everything from her, knowing the penalties is death. So he wanted to work something out. Just like today, I didn't set up the rules. I didn't set up the punishments. The Most High did. So you talking to me about trying to work things out as far as going to, you know, letting Congress go ahead and fix everything or trying to vote some new people in, I have no control over punishments, over laws, over any of that. So I'm the wrong person to be trying to have a conversation with, trying to work out a plan with. That's kind of like, you know, you guys burned my house down and I was at work. So you want to try to negotiate something with my 10-year-old son before I get home. Well, just like my 10-year-old son would not have that kind of authority to make that kind of an agreement. Neither do the Israelites have that kind of, you know, of authority to make that kind of agreement with you guys. So if you want to talk about the whole 400 years and having to pay for it, you're not going to be talking to me. I'm like that 10-year-old kid. Hey, I don't have any authority here. You're going to have to wait and talk to my dad when he gets here. That's exactly what's going on right now. People are waiting right now. We're waiting for our dad to get here. He'll be here in a minute. Don't worry. No, we're not going to make any agreements right now. I can't do anything. I know you want me to sign this check or whatever else, you know, that you guys are trying to give me. But no, I can't sign. I don't have that kind of authority. You need to wait until my dad gets here. But see, they don't want to wait until dad gets here because they already know what he said is due. And they're trying to, you know, trying to get us to agree to something before he gets here. You know, I'm like, I'm not signing anything. I'll just let you go ahead and deal with my father. As you can tell, he's already really close. I think I see his headlights right there on down the street. He's already bringing some pain. Just imagine what's really about to come. Well, let's see what's going to come. Let's see what happens here in the story. Okay. Let's see. Making sure I get the right place here. Verse 26. Let's read 25 again. For our land is very extensive, so dwell ye and trade therein and get possessions in it, and do therein as you desire. And no one shall prevent you by saying a word to you. Okay. And Tamar ceased speaking unto Jacob and his sons. And behold, Shechem, his son, had come after him. And he sat before them. And Shechem spoke before Jacob and his sons, saying, may I find favor in your sight, that you will give me your daughter. And whatsoever you say unto me, that will I do for her. So kind of like right now, what do you guys want? You guys want us to start, you know, you put these people in jail? We'll do that. You want us to start passing legislation? We'll do that. Whatever it is you guys want, that's what we'll do. Okay? Ask me for abundance of dowry and gift, and I will give it. And whatsoever you shall say unto me, that will I do. And whosoever he be that will rebel against your orders, he shall die. Only give me the damsel for a woman. And Simon and Levi answered Shamor and Shechem, his son, deceitfully, saying, all you have spoken unto us, we will do for you. And behold, our daughter, or our sister, is in your house. But keep away from her until we send to our father, okay, Isaac, concerning this matter. For we can do nothing without his consent. For he knows the ways of our father Abraham. And whatsoever he says unto us, we will tell you. We will conceal nothing from you. Okay, so the brethren were being a little deceitful as to what they're about to do to them. And Simon and Levi spoke unto Shechem and his father in order to find a pretext and to seek counsel, which was to be done to Shechem and to his city in this matter. So they're trying to plan out what they're about to do to them. So they're not trying to sit here and work things out. But see, this is what happens right now. You're going to have people, I guess, right now, you know, that are trying to work everything out. And it's pretty much like you hear them like saying, like right now, like, what do you guys want? Like, especially all of these sports broadcasters. Like, look, man, you know, they're trying to fix stuff. They're trying to pass some laws. What do you guys want? What do you guys expect? That's what's going on with a lot of these sellouts right now that they just put in front of us. You can easily see spirits right now. You can see what spirits in each individual right now. You know, you can tell that many people are paid off. And it's like, you know, they're just trying to get everything back into normal so that they can start to put, you know, those blinders on the people again and go back to life as usual. But as you can see, as the events that are coming on in the world right now, the things that are happening, there is not going to be any rush to go back to normalcy. As much as the other nations are trying their best to go back to normalcy, it's not going to happen. Okay? Let's see here. And when Shechem and his father heard the words of Simon and Levi, it seemed good in their sight. And Shechem and his father came forth to go home. And when they had gone, the sons of Jacob said unto their father, saying, Behold, we know that death is due to these wicked, unto these wicked ones, and to their city, because they transgressed that which Elohim had commanded unto Noah and his children and his seed after them. See, they're following what the Most High had already told. You know, they're following the laws of the Most High. The other nations are still, you know, thinking that they can just make a deal. Let's make a deal. That's what they're trying to do. Just like today. They think they can just make up whatever rules they want. Hey, yeah, we know we've done all these things to you guys for 400 years, but we're not going to give you guys any revenue. We're not going to give you guys any money. We're not going to, you know, give you guys anything for all the hundreds of years of free labor. No. Someone, was it Mitch McConnell said, yeah, your guys' payment was we elected a black president. You see what I'm saying? Because they seem to think that they make the laws and that they don't have to follow the laws of the Most High. Like, the Most High's retribution is null and void. The way he wants to, you know, pad out retribution is null and void. You know, we're not giving you guys any reparations. We took everything and we're not going to give you guys anything back. Because what we will do is we'll pass some laws. How about that? You see what I'm saying? That's what they're used to doing. They think they hold all the cards, which they don't. Okay? Let's see here. Checking here. All right, 35. And also because Shechem did this thing to our sister Dinah in defiling her, for such vileness shall never be done amongst us. Now therefore, know and see what you will do, and seek counsel and pretext what it is to be done to them in order to kill all the inhabitants of the city. So they're looking, they're not looking to just kill one person, they're looking to kill everybody. Okay. And Simon said to them, here is a proper advice for you. Tell them to circumcise every male amongst them, as we are circumcised. And if they do not wish to do this, we shall take our daughter from them and go away. And if they consent to do this and will do it, then when they are sunk down and with pain, we will attack them with our swords, as upon one who is quiet and peaceable. And we will slay every male person amongst them. So like I said, these Hebrews aren't playing. Okay? And Simon's advice pleased them, and Simon and Levi are resolved to do unto them as it was proposed. And on the next morning, Shechem and Chamor with his father came again unto Jacob and his sons to speak concerning Dinah and to hear what answer the sons of Jacob would give to their words. And the sons of Jacob spoke deceitfully to them, saying, we told our father, you know, Isaac, all your words and your words please him. But he spoke unto us, saying, thus Abraham, his father commanded from the Elohim Yahweh of the whole earth, that any man who is not of his descendants that should wish to take on one of his daughters shall cause every male belonging to him to be circumcised as we are circumcised, and then we may give him our daughter for a woman. Okay. Now we have made known to you all our ways that our father spoke unto us, for we cannot do this of which you spoke unto us, to give our daughter to an uncircumcised man, for it is a disgrace to us. But herein will we consent to you, to give you our daughter, and we will also take unto ourselves your daughters, and will dwell amongst you and be one people, as you have spoken. Okay? If you will hearken to us and consent to be like us, to circumcise every male belonging to you, as we are circumcised. So same kind of thing with the Most High right now. You got a lot of people now seeming to think that, you know, all they have to do is just acknowledge the 400 years. This isn't us. This is the Most High. You know, a lot of people now all of a sudden think that, hey, you know, I don't have to pay for anything. you know, I'm screwed up too. I'm in a screwed up situation now too. So let's all just get together and work all of this out together right now. So that's like the Most High. These people, he's giving them like a fake a fake feeling of solidarity. These people have a sense of solidarity in the story because, oh, okay, you know, we're going to work everything out. We'll just circumcise our men and we'll be cool. Same kind of thing with the Most High. The Most High don't play. He's giving everybody their warning. He's letting them see the 400 years. So that, you know, the Most High always gave us our warning through omens, through prophets. He let us know why we were getting our butts kicked, why we were about to get destroyed. He's doing exactly the same thing to the Gentiles. He's letting you guys know, yeah, you had these people, my people, in subjugation for 400 to 500 plus years. And now you seem to think that all you have to say is Black Lives Matter, we're all together, throw down a couple of statues, and we're cool. That's enough. I forgive you. But see, same things happen in the story. The whole world is being deceived. They think this is going to be a really quick and easy fix. And it's not going to be. Same thing is happening right here in this story. Okay? 43. Now we have made known to you all our ways that our father spoke unto us, for we cannot do this of which you spoke unto us, to give our daughters to an uncircumcised man, or is a disgrace to us, okay? So, like I said, we know that. They're telling them, you know, it's a disgrace, but, you know, we'll work it out this way. So same thing right now. You guys seem to think that it's just, we're all good. We're gonna work everything together. And we watch the news. We're making some progress. You know, look, we put a couple of people in jail. That doesn't make up for the last 500 plus years of you guys letting all these people off and all the things that have happened to our people. So now, 46. And Shechem and his father, Shamor, heard the words of the sons of Jacob, and the thing pleased them exceedingly. And Shechem and his father, Shamor, hastened to do the wishes of the sons of Jacob, for Shechem was very fond of Dinah, and his soul was riveted to her. And Shechem and his father, Shamor, hastened to the gate of the city, and they assembled all the men of their city, and spoke unto them the words of the sons of Jacob, saying, we came to these men, the sons of Jacob, and we spoke unto them concerning their daughter. And these men will consent to do according to our wishes. And behold, our land is of great extent for them. And they will dwell in it and trade in it. And we shall be one people. And we will take their daughters, and our daughters we will give unto them for women. But only on this condition will these men consent to do this thing, that every male amongst us be circumcised, okay, as they are circumcised, as their Elohim commanded them. And when we shall have done according to their instructions to be circumcised, then they will dwell amongst us, together with their cattle and possessions, and we shall be as one people with them, okay? And when all the men of the city heard the words of Shechem and his father Shamor, then all the men of their city were agreeable to this proposal. And they obeyed to be circumcised, for Shechem and his father Shamor were greatly esteemed by them, being the princes of the land. Okay? So that's what's going on, like I said, right now. We're in 51. And on the next day, Shechem and Shamor, his father, rose up early in the morning, and they assembled all the men of their city, okay, into the middle of the city, and they called for the sons of Jacob, who circumcised every male belonging to them on that day and the next. That must have been a fun job. And they circumcised Shechem and Shamor, his father, and the five brothers of Shechem, and then everyone rose up and went home, for this thing was from Yahweh against the city of Shechem. See, this is the Most High. It wasn't just they put these things in their minds. The Most High has put these thoughts in their minds, and he's the one that's working behind the scenes. Okay? Okay, so again, for this thing was from Yahweh against the city of Shechem, and from Yahweh was Simon's counsel in this manner. So the Most High was telling Simon about this, to do this, in order that Yahweh might deliver the city of Shechem into the hands of Jacob's two sons. All right, so now we're going to go to chapter 34. We're going to be a little bit there. And the number of all the males that were circumcised were 645 men and 246 children. But Chidekem, son of Bered, the father of Chamor, and his six brothers would not listen unto Shechem, and his father Chamor, and they would not be circumcised. But the proposal of the sons of Jacob was loathsome in their sight, and their anger was greatly aroused at this. But the people of the city had not hearkened to them. Okay? So like even like today, you got a lot of people right now that are not down with, you know, trying to work things out with our people. Okay? So like I said, not everybody is down, of course, with, you know, trying to work things out with our people because of the destruction that they brought on us. Many of them know that they're, you know, they know the laws. They know that they're not going to be able to work, you know, just weasel their way out of these kinds of things. Okay? All right, so we've got Joshua 34 and 3. And in the evening of the second day, they found eight small children who had not been circumcised, for their mothers had concealed them from Shechem and his father Chamor, and from the men of the city. And Shechem and his father Chamor sent to have them brought before them to be circumcised. When Chedekem and his six brothers sprang at them with their swords and sought to slay them. And they sought to slay also Shechem and his father Chamor, and they sought to slay Dinah with them, okay, on account of this matter. And they said unto them, what is this thing that you have done? Are there no women amongst our daughters, amongst the daughters of your brethren, okay, the Canaanites, that you wish to take unto yourselves, daughters of the Hebrews, whom ye knew not before, and will do this act, which your fathers never commanded you? Do you imagine that you will succeed through this act which you have done? And what will you answer in this affair to your brethren, the Canaanites? Who will come tomorrow and ask you concerning this thing? And if your act shall not appear just and good in their sight, what will you do for your lives and me for our lives if you're not having hearkened to our voices? And if the inhabitants of the land and all your brethren, the children of Ham, shall hear of your act, saying, on account of a Hebrew woman did Shechem and Chamor his father, and all the inhabitants of their city do that which they had been unacquainted, and which their ancestors never commanded them. Where then will you fly, or where conceal your shame all your days before your brethren, the inhabitants of the land of Canaan? Now therefore, we cannot bear up against this thing which you have done, neither can we be burdened with this yoke upon us, okay, which our ancestors did not command us. So we're having a good conversation right here. Behold, tomorrow we will go and assemble all our brethren, the Canaanite brethren, who dwell in the land, and we will all come and smite you and all those who trust in you, and there shall not be a remnant left from you or them. And when Chamor and son of Shechem and all the people of the city heard the words of Chidekem and his brothers, they were terribly afraid, and their lives at the words. Okay, hold on. At their words, and they repented of what they had done. And Shechem and his father Chamor answered their father Chidekem and his brethren, and they said unto them, all the words which you spoke unto us are true. Now do not say, or nor imagine in your hearts, that on account of the love of the Hebrew, we did this thing that our ancestors did not command us, but because we saw that it was not their intention and desire to accede to our wishes concerning their daughter, but as to our taking her, except on this condition. So we hearkened to their voices and did this act which you saw, in order to abstain our desire from them. And when we shall have obtained our request from them, we will then return to them and do unto them that which you say unto us. So now they're going to go and try to kill the Hebrews. Okay? We beseech you then to wait and tarry until our flesh shall be healed, and we again become strong, and we will then go together against them and do unto them that which is in your hearts and in ours. So now they're going to get together and go against the Hebrews. So like, don't attack us. Just wait for us to heal, and we'll get together. We'll join forces and go and destroy Jacob and his sons. Okay. So 19. And Dinah, the daughter of Jacob, heard all these words which Chittekum and his brothers had spoken, and what Chamor and his son Shechem, and the people of their city had answered them. And she hastened and sent one of her maidens that her father had sent to take care of her in the house of Shechem to Jacob, her father, and to her brethren, saying, "This did Chittekum and his brothers advise concerning you." And thus did Chamor and Shechem and the people of the city answer them. And when Jacob heard these words, he was filled with wrath, and he was indignant at them, and his anger was kindled against them. And Simon and Levi swore and said, "As Yahweh lives, the Elohim of the whole earth, by this time tomorrow, there shall not be a remnant left in the whole city." And 20 young men had concealed themselves who were not circumcised. And these young men fought against Simon and Levi. And Simon and Levi killed 18 of them. And two fled from them and escaped to some lime pits that were in the city. And Simon and Levi sought for them, but could not find them. And Simon and Levi continued to go about in the city, and they killed all the people of the city at the edge of the sword. And they left none remaining. And there was a great consternation in the midst of the city. And the cry of the people of the city ascended to heaven, and all the women and children cried aloud. And Simon and Levi slew all the city. They left not a male remaining in the whole city. And they slew Chamor and Shechem, his son, at the edge of the sword. And they brought away Dinah from the house of Shechem, and they went from there. And the sons of Jacob went and returned and came upon the slain and spoiled all their property, which was in the city and the land, or sorry, and the field. And while they were taking the spoil, 300 men stood up and threw dust at them and struck them with stones. When Simon turned to them, he slew them all with the edge of the sword. And Simon turned before Levi, okay, and came into the city. And they looked away, okay, they took away their sheep and their oxen and their cattle, and also the remainder of the women and little ones. And they led all these away, and they opened the gate and went out and came unto their father Jacob with vigor. And when Jacob saw all that they had done to the city, and saw the spoil that they took from them, Jacob was very angry at them. And Jacob said unto them, "What is this that you have done to me? Behold, I obtained rest amongst the Canaanites, inhabitants of the land, and none of them meddled with me. And now you have done to make me obnoxious to the inhabitants of the land, amongst the Canaanites and the Perizzim. I am but a small number, but they will all assemble against me and slay me when they hear of your work with their brethren, and I and my household will be destroyed." Okay, so he wasn't very happy with the destruction of the city. Okay, and Simeon and Levi and all their brothers with them answered their father Jacob and said unto him, "Behold, we live in the land, and shall Shechem do this to our sister? Why are you silent at all that Shechem has done? Will he deal with our sister as with a harlot in the streets?" And the number of the women whom Simon and Levi took captives from the city of Shechem, whom they did not slay, was 85, who had not known man. Okay. So, he said, a lot of the things are playing out the same way as the story. Many people, you know, they got the opportunity, the Most High let them know, because trust me, you wouldn't hear anybody talking about the 400 years before this happened. You have no one, even still, they try to ignore the 400-year plight of our people. He said, we know it's been longer than that, but the fact that they're even bringing it up. When all of the distractions were here, they could care less. The Most High allowed them to see what they had done to our people. He let them see a little bit of it. They're trying to fix it by passing laws, tearing down statues, protesting with us, seeming as if that's all that they need to do. Just like Shechem seemed to think, oh, okay, if I just go ahead and just, you know, do the circumcision thing, we'll all be one people. Just like today, okay, if we go ahead and pass some laws, we can all be one people, right? But they still want to be on top. Just like the people here with them, the Canaanites wanted to be on top. But as you can see, the Most High has different plans. The Most High has laws. He has certain laws that have to be, you know, fulfilled, you know, have to be implemented, have to be enforced. They don't get to enforce their laws of the Gentiles. They're going to, the Most High is coming to enforce his laws. Oh, I think I just saw his lights. I think he's in the driveway now. So now the other nations are going to have to go ahead and have to deal with him. So trying to get me to sign off, you know, on the stuff they've done to us, sign off on, oh, okay, this is all they have to pay. Nope. I said, you're going to have to deal with my father now. And I think he's getting ready to get out of the car now. So you guys are going to have a chance to actually talk to him and see what he is going to demand from you now that we're at the end. All praise is to the Most High, Yahweh. Acknowledge to the earthly mother, who is wisdom, who is Holy Spirit. Acknowledgement to Yahweh Shai. Shalom.